Hey gorgeous people, welcome to Weld.com. Today we're going to be doing a man versus machine episode. So what we're going to be doing is I'm going to be beveling one plate, and the machine, it's a Gullco machine, KDM-18, is going to be beveling one side of the plate. We're going to be beveling 3/8 plate, and it's going to be 10 feet long, all right? So let's go ahead and start the race. All right, so what process I'm using is flux core. I'm using the spray transfer. I'm using the ESOP E35i Rebel. I'm using 7030 select arc wire 045 with neural drive rolls. I'm running 7525, I'm running about 35 CFH. And yeah, that's about it. I tack every 35 inches to make sure the plate's not gonna move while I'm beveling it. All right, so what I'm gonna be doing here first, I'm gonna bevel about an inch of it, inch and a half, with this little grinder. I want to set my angle. We're aiming for 30 degrees. I'm going to be using this to check my angle, get it dialed in when within a couple degrees. Once I like it, I'm going to switch over to 7.5. But I'm going to use this wheel, this Weld right here, Big Cat, 40 grit. I want something aggressive. You don't want something fine, and it's going to take you forever. All right, higher the number, finer it is. You want coarser number. I mean, lower the number, coarser. So I got 40 grit. Remember that, all right? And also, you can tell if it's rough right here, it's a lower number. It's pretty rough. So 7-inch, I'm gonna do this one, do the big boys grinder. I'm just gonna be using this Tiger ceramic. After I do my 2-inch and get my bevel set, I'm gonna do this all the way down, all right, on this 1/4-inch hard rock. And hopefully it flies pretty quick. I'm not gonna work the whole dang thing or work 6 inches at once. I'm gonna work a little bit at a time, all the way down. I'm not working like this. Work a little bit and keep going like that. I think it's counterproductive when you're working good 6 inches. All right, I'm gonna work a little bit and look at the front edge of my grinding wheel, all right, and see what it's doing. Now I'm just gonna carry that bevel 30 degrees all the way down, all right? That's it, nice and simple. I'm gonna throw my safety gear on, earplugs, face mask, cover my neck up because I don't like the grinding crap on me, face mask, shield, MCR stuff, and we're good to go. Took my degree finder at 30 degrees. I mean, 60 degrees I set it at, because we're running off of 90. 90 minus 30 is 60. Set that on here. And took my soapstone and kind of laid it out so I wouldn't over grind. Then I took my square, set it to that line on the top of this plate, and just dragged that line all the way down. What that's gonna do is help you stop from over grinding and wasting your time, wasting your money. But still, obviously, I suck still. I still was over grinding by like an 1/8 inch. So that's what I did there. And 1/8 inch on the land, I basically did the same thing. I just kind of set my land and took my square and drew it all the way down there. Same thing. So I went over grind, kind of keep consistent. I used a little 4-inch wheel, 4-inch hand grinder Metabo to set my little, set my bevel by hand at first, to set the right angle I want and get it fine tuned in with it. That's what I did exactly with it. Or not fine tuned, just like get the angle I wanted basically. And after I got that, I went over to the big 7.5-inch wheel, hard rock on there, and just started beveling with the Weiler and just kept beveling. And it was long and forever, it felt like. And just had to sit down and just kept moving all the way down, carrying that same angle. Then after I got that done, well, I didn't really get that done. I started having problems down the middle. I was getting fatigued, tired. I was grinding very consistent. So I switched over to a flapper wheel. That started speeding me up a little bit. Then that thing started wearing out. So that's why I like the hard rocks. They stay nice and consistent and they stay brand new for a long time. And I just switched back over there and just kind of kept consistent again and finally got it done. Then I took a flapper disc and just kind of fine tuned in my degrees on this within the tolerance of it, 6 degrees, a couple more, a couple less. So yeah, that's what I did on mine. All right, I just got done beveling this plate. It took me roughly about 46 minutes and 12 seconds to be exact. But I think I did pretty good, pretty quick. This is the way I did it. This is what works for me. So let's go ahead and see what this machine could do. All right, so this is like a little makeshift jig right now. So I had to use this I-beam because this plate's not wide enough. Out in the field, you would have like a 15-foot wide plate, by like 35 feet long or 50 feet long. That's what I'm used to running. So, and this plate's only 3/8 thick, so I want to make sure it's staying kind of straight or basically almost straight. So I use this I-beam. The I-beam don't have much of a sag in it. It's almost perfect. It's the closest thing I have on hand. So I tipped it up vertical, weld the bottom of it, and put tacks. Gullco wants you to tack every, 35 to 45 inches. That's the best way, he said. So I did it all the way down. So right now, all we gotta do is grind this draw soft right here for the machine to start, and we're gonna pre-grind about 1.5 inches of this, an inch. All right, then we're gonna go ahead and just set that machine up, and she's just going all the way down by itself. So I'm just using a thicker grain if you wanna get stuff done fast. It's about 36 grit, so we're gonna just hit about 1 inch. Like I said, we're hitting this off right here. All right, see how easy that was? That was pretty quick. All I had to do is pre-bevel that and set this up there, level this up 30 degrees. This could do from 22.5 degrees all the way up to 55 degrees. It could bevel thick as 19 millimeters thick plate. By the way, we don't need no earplugs. I don't know why I got earplugs in. Right here, we can have a conversation and talk normally. And guess what? This is what's really cool. It's not hot. See it? That's really good. Easy to fit up. When you cut this or anything or put what heat into your metal, it's gonna warp it. So when your metal warps, it's gonna be harder on the fitter, and it's gonna be harder on the welder too, because it's gonna be a inconsistent root opening, inconsistent bevel. You're gonna be inconsistent. And also this keeps your bevel really nice and straight. So a welder will have a better looking weld. Look, it's done. So we got a little land right here up front, about 1/8 inch right here. This is not hot, and there's no burrs either. Nothing. I mean, I'm hitting this with my fingers. It's not even cutting me. So the machine got done running, ran 10 feet. All right, 30 degrees, 1/8 inch land. So yeah, that machine did okay. It only beat me by 45 minutes. And 9 seconds. So it did it in 1:03. That's pretty bad, huh? That's pretty bad. I think I won still. But yeah, that machine beat my butt. I mean, it's embarrassed. 1:03, how can you beat that? Seriously, 1:03. It's impossible, no one's gonna beat that. All right, so let's do a little comparison plate. So this is the plate I grind right here. And this is the machine, the Gullco machine that did its beveling on. So we did 60 degrees. We're gonna do a little quick measurement here. So why am I doing this? Because I want to see if I remove too much metal or the machine removed too much metal. So we're going to measure a foot down. So I already got a foot here. I'm just going to measure across here. So I'm at 7 11/16 and an 1/8 inch land. Let's measure this one more time. 7 13/16 and 1/8 inch land. So I got 11/16 on mine and 13/16. So 13/16 minus 11/16 is the 1/8 inch. I'm removing 1/8 inch of material extra than the machine. That's pretty bad. What it comes down to, I'm wasting money, wasting time, wasting my time and the company's time. And I'm wasting grinding wheels, grinding more. But the Weiler grinding factories love me because I'm over grinding for sure. But yeah, and also, man, I was getting tore up. So that's one test we're testing right now. That's one way we're going to check. So another way is we're going to check it with this and check our 60 degrees compared to mine, compared to this machine. So let's do the machine first. So we're going to check. So this is at 60 on the money. We're going to just slide it up over here. Oh, damn. I don't even see no light through this thing. Holy crap. Let's check in more than one spot, random spots. Oh my God, I check like 4 or 5 spots. It's like perfect. Perfect. Shit. Mine, I was in a hurry. Oh, I see light. Let's make it different. Let's adjust it like you would do when you're inspecting. So I'm at 63 degrees. So that's 1 degree. If you're doing really tight tolerances, that's 1 degree over. They would do in like critical work, like boiler work or modules, nuclear modules. So I can't really check right here. Let's push this down a little bit more. So I already know I'm gonna be inconsistent. So let's adjust right here. So I'm at 66. So I'm at 66 and what, 64? That's pretty inconsistent, and that was just two spots. I'm not checking no more. But you already can tell I'm inconsistent. My land's gonna be inconsistent because I'm in a hurry. I'm trying to get it done. It's not gonna be good as that machine. I mean, that machine's beating my butt all day. And it did it in 1 minute and 3 seconds. Took me 45 something minutes. And it ran colder and it didn't use no disc. The disc life of that, or the neural cutters on it, is 6,000 to 10,000 feet you get out of that if you use it properly by the book. That's with steel or stainless. I mean, it's gonna be way cheaper going that way, I think. And I'm not numb. I'm numbed right here still. But yeah, that thing whipped my butt. God dang it. That was hard, guys. I wanna cry. I wanna sit down and cry right now. So if you guys got log grinding, definitely get this machine. It's definitely worth your while. Even if you have a welding school, I just figured this out. I'm gonna start beveling my plates with that thing. Just, you cut your plate 6 inches long, 4 inches wide, and just feed it through, 5 seconds. That's gonna be the best way for me for beveling. Learning is key. My name's Man Cub. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Holidays, stay safe.